On the line with us, Anthony Torres, the climate organizer and activist and spokesperson with the Sunrise Movement. The website is sunrisemovement.org. You can tweet Anthony at AV Torres, T-O-R-R-E-S, number 4, or at Sunrise MVMT, as in movement. Anthony, welcome to the program.
Hi, Tom. Thank you for having me.
Great to have you with us. So tell us about the Sunrise Movement.
Yeah, so the Sunrise Movement is organizing an army of young people to take on the culprits of our climate crisis, the fossil fuel CEOs who have profited off of climate disaster and who are blocking our path to the action and the just society we need.
I would argue that the blood of at least some of the people who have died in Houston is on the hands of some of these fossil fuel CEOs who have intentionally had their companies lie to us in the press and buy off politicians and intimidate media organizations to deny climate change. And at the top of that list, I would put Rex Tillerson and the guy Lee Raymond, the guy who preceded him, the one who looks curiously like Mike Myers' old fat bastard character from the movies. In your opinion, am I being hyperbolic here, Anthony?
So Rex Tillerson made his millions as ExxonMobil CEO, and he secured his position as Secretary of State by poisoning the air and water of Houston residents long before the storm and pitting us against each other with this claim that for one community to thrive, another must suffer. And so, you know, we're seeing in this storm, I'm not sure if you've been down to Houston, but you know, Exxon has a huge facility out on the East End that has been fuming the air and water for fence line communities for years. And now some of these various facilities, including one this morning, a chemical factory, has spewed even more pollution into an already devastated community. And so this disaster by Harvey is not natural. It's a man-made climate disaster perpetrated by fossil fuel CEOs like Tillerson, and shouldered on Black, brown, immigrant, disabled, indigenous, and poor Americans.
I understand that you guys were talking with Anthony Torres. He's a spokesperson with the Sunrise Movement. Sunrisemovement.org is the website. That you all are going to be holding a vigil at Rex Tillerson's home here in Washington, D.C. Do I have that right?
Yep, absolutely.
Tell us about
it. Tonight at 7 p.m., we're going to be going into the heart of the California neighborhood of D.C., where Rex Tillerson has his D.C. residence. And at 7 p.m., we're going to hold a vigil of mourning and reckoning, where we're going to mourn our sisters and brothers in Texas, but also in Bangladesh, Mumbai, Sierra Leone, those who have been drowning in their homes from climate disaster.
Yeah, over 1,000 people in South Asia now have died from these. You know, they're having monsoons, but they're far worse than normal because, again, they're being fueled by climate change, too. Forgive my interrupting.
No, absolutely. And so, you know, we're holding this despair and outrage that we have to leverage resources at this vigil for a family on the front line. And we believe it's our duty to condemn those responsible for these human catastrophes, the oil barons and politicians who profit off these disasters. And so we're going to be raising money for local organizations such as Tejas, Latina Trans Texas, South Texas Human Rights Center, the Hurricane Harvey Community Relief Fund, National Black United Front of Greater Houston. And so movement leaders as well as D.C. residents are going to be coming together tonight to shine a light on those responsible and provide support to our family.
So the is it pronounced Calamara? Neighborhood?
Calorama neighborhood.
Calorama, thank you.
This is like the
swankiest, fanciest, most expensive part of Washington, D.C. It's where the Obamas bought a house. It's where Jared and Ivanka Kushner are living. Do they have like, you know, gated communities and things? Do they have some way of keeping you out, or can you actually stand on the street with a sign out in front of Rex Tillerson's house?
Yeah, I've been a visitor to that neighborhood and brought protests to the, you know, that affluent site of D.C. before. And we're planning on convening in a park that's the closest park to the DuPont Center, DuPont Circle Metro Station, and will be marching through the streets and holding space in front of his residence. And so, you know, this is definitely one of the most exclusive neighborhoods of D.C. You're right. Ivanka Trump and others are claiming to be home. And we're going to be, you know, speaking truth to power right in their front door.
Yeah. Good on you. Anthony Torres is a climate organizer, activist, and spokesperson with the Sunrise Movement. If you want more details, you can go to sunrisemovement.org. You can tweet him at AV Torres, T-O-R-R-E-S, number 4, or at Sunrise MVMT, as in movement. And this is great. Young people taking the message to the perps, as it were. Anthony, I wish you the very best.
Thanks so much, Tom.
Thanks for being with us today, Anthony.